collectibles. Coins, rings, anything you can collect. It's a fun addition to your project. In this video, I will show you how to add collectibles to your game. I already have the scene set up. I'll just place in a graphic object that will be our collectible. Now, many people will just add the behaviors within this coin object, but there's a more easy and reliable way to make collectibles work. Let's add a tag to this object. I'll call it collectible. You can name it whatever you want, just keep a note of it. In another object that is not a collectible, we can program how our collectibles work collectively. I'll promise it'll make sense. Sense. Am I funny? No? Okay. Anyways, I will program the collectible mechanism in the player object. I programmed it so when the player collides with the collectible tag, the collided object is destroyed. There are two ways that we can do this. Reference the object that the player collided with, or reference the collectible tag. The cool thing about tags is that behaviors involving interaction with one object at a time, like started touching and colliding, will have the behaviors referencing that tag to use the object that was touched or collided with. So instead of destroying all the coins like how it would normally work, it just destroys the coin that it has collided with. Tags are very useful when manipulating a group of objects. There's so many awesome things about tags that it can be a whole video on its own. Now, enough about tags, let's playtest! Bob is eating coins. Yummy! But notice that Bob's momentum stops when colliding with a coin. This is because the coins aren't passable. So let's make them passable. When something isn't passable, other objects can have physical interactions with it where collisions can cause changes. When something is passable, objects can freely pass through each other like ghosts. Collisions don't affect the objects at all, but collision behaviors will still work. So now, when we playtest, we can see that Bob can eat all the coins without any physical resistance. Yummy! Jeez, how much can you eat? You haven't even gained a single pound, what? Ignoring Bob's supernatural ability of consuming huge amount of objects in a short period of time effortlessly without gaining any weight like Kirby, let's go back to our behaviors and add a pickup sound effect. That line. Who wrote this script? Oh wait, I did. I'm the only one here. Anyways, yeah, let's add a sound effect. We can also have a label that will keep track of how many coins Bob has collected. In our behaviors, we can use add to score to increment the counter. It will add by 1 each time and it can go infinitely. Now, let's playtest our project again. It's satisfying to collect coins because of the extra sensory feedback we put in, which is having a counter and playing a sound effect. Now, we can make it even more satisfying if the pitch of the sound effect increased each time, like in Temple Run, Subway Surfers, Mario Kart Tour. I'm going to set a value behavior which will keep track of the current pitch. I will rename it for convenience. I will add this value by 1 every time and set the value to the result of this add behavior. The play sound behavior will use the value output field in its pitch input field. I am also going to place a wait behavior of 3 seconds or somewhere around that, which will reset the current pitch value to 0. Every time the wait behavior is executed, it will reset its clock every time. So only after you stop collecting coins for 3 seconds, the pitch will reset.
It's time to play test again.
Music to my ears. We can take this further and use attributes. We can have different types of collectibles that can do different things. Let's say we have red coins that are worth 5 regular coins for whatever reason.
Hey, that's the only thing I can think of right now.
You stood off from Temple Run, idiot.
No, I didn't take that from Temple Run.
You're capping. Lie to me again and I will let Bob into your bank account.
Okay, fine.
I will set an attribute, type to red. And in our collectible mechanism, every time we collect a coin, get the attribute value from the object and check, is this a red coin? If it is a red coin, then add 4 to the coin counter. All coins already add 1 to the score, so red coins just have to get 4 extra coins. Okay, one final touch. Let's add particles. I want to create particles for the collectibles to make them look more appetizing.
What? Bob's gonna eat them, not me.
Luckily, this asset pack contains the perfect graphic to use to make this particle effect. The particle should last forever, there shouldn't be many particles, and it's randomly scattered around a small area, and boom, there we go. Back in our player object, I can just use the start particles behavior. Select the collectible tag and pick the particle. Now, playtesting it, Bob has never been more excited to eat some shiny coins. Oh no, I'm getting hungry too. That will be all for this video. If you want to see more content like this, please consider following our Instagram and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Comment what you would like to see next, and you could be selected for the next video. See you later.